So good morning one and all. So let us start today's class with a new topic, that is transforms. So they are very, very important. Why? Because they make our job very easy. How? So the transform of a distribution of random variable x, also called as movement generating function. So please remember, it is also called movement generating function, the short form MGF. It is, suppose if x is a random variable, its transform is denoted with mx of parameter s, or sometimes you can omit this x, you can simply write m of s. This is a notation of the transform of a random variable x. Here it is a function of s, just like Laplace transform. How it is defined? It is defined like this. That is expectation of e power s into capital X. So this expectation operation. Okay. Suppose if X is discrete, generally what is the formula of expectation? Expectation of X equal to summation over x, x into px of x. What is this? This is a PMF. Now, what will be the formula of e power sx? This is the formula of e power sx. It is nothing but mx of s. If you want, you can write. Otherwise, no need to write. If there is only one random variable, simply you can denote the transform with m of s. Now, what is the formula? Summation over x, e power sx into px of x. What is this? What is this? This is the PMF. Why PMF? Because x is a discrete random variable. If it is continuous, suppose what is the expectation of x in case of continuous? Integration minus to plus infinity x into its PDF. Isn't it? Now what about the formula? What about the transform if it is, if x is continuous random variable? So integration minus to plus infinity e power sx fx of x dx. This is the PDF. Now these are the two formulas for discrete and continuous random variables. Okay. Now, so they are just like, suppose if I say x is continuous, let me take. So what is m of s formula? Integration minus to plus infinity e power sx fx of x dx. Isn't it? Yes or no? Now it is similar to which formula? Suppose that is well known transform. What is that? Laplace transform. X of t having a Laplace transform of x of s. What is x of s formula? Minus to plus infinity x of t into e minus st dt. They are very similar. The only difference is here we say e power sx. Here we say e power minus st. That is a basic difference. Okay, it's just like a Laplace transform. So for discrete case, what is the formula? This formula. It is similar to which transforms? Similar to what transform? Z transform. Okay. So they are similar to well-known Laplace and Z transforms. Is it okay? Right. Now you take this example. For this, you have to find out the transform of the random variable x. So x is a discrete random variable. Now they gave us the PMF, it is defined like this, and what is a, it is its transform or its movement generating function. What is m of s? M of s equal to, what is the formula first of all? Summation over x, what is that? E power sx into its PMF. Now It is defined when x equal to, so if you go to the problem, it is defined when x equal to 2, 3, 5, isn't it? So that's why I'll take only those values of x only. So when x equal to 2, e power 2s. When x equal to, what is the PMF? 1 by 2 plus. When x equal to 3, when x equal to 3, when x equal to 3, this become e power 3s by, what is the corresponding PMF value? 6, 1 by 6, so 1 by 6 plus e power 5s by, what is the value? 3, 1 by 3. So this is the, its transform M of s, or it is also called as movement generating function, MGF. Okay, now so you remember this, we'll do this after some time also. Okay, right, so let us move on to the another thing, that is, so the transform of exponential random variable, the transform of a exponential random variable. So let us find out this. So first of all, what is the PDF of exponential random variable? Fx of x equal to lambda is a positive parameter, e power minus lambda x, when x is greater than or equal to 0, 0 otherwise. I have written so many times, isn't it? Now they are asking its transform, M of s. Now, okay, let us make it fast. What are the limits of x? 0 to infinity, correct? Next, lambda into e power minus lambda x into e power what? Sx dx, isn't it? Now lambda is anyway parameter, you can keep outside integration. Now 0 to infinity, so what you can say, e power, if I take minus x common, if I take minus x common, what do you get? Lambda minus s dx. So please be careful, I have taken here minus x as a common, is it okay? Now what will happen? Now can you calculate this integral? So lambda into, so e power minus, sorry, e power minus x into lambda minus s by minus lambda minus s. This is 0 to infinity. What do you get? If you solve this, what do you get? Lambda by, so e power minus infinity is 0. E power 0 is 1. So minus minus cancel, lambda by lambda minus s. But here there is one thing. So when it is convergent, it is convergent when lambda is more than s. If lambda is less than s, it diverges to infinity. It is not finite value. So you must write this condition. It is finite at this condition only. It is something like ROC. What is ROC means? Region of convergence. In Laplace transforms, while finding its transform, you always mention ROC, right? In the same way, here also, it is valid in this region only. If it is not satisfied, here you may get infinity, or here your integral may not be finite. Okay, you must mention this condition. It's something like ROC of a Laplace transform. Okay. So lambda by lambda minus s. Okay, that is the here what you got? M of s equal to lambda by lambda minus s. This also you remember, we will use this later. Okay. Now, so what is the transform of a linear function of a random variable? Now here, y is a function of x. How they are defined? Ax plus b, isn't it? Now what is the transform of y? Okay, so here I mentioned very clearly. So transform of y equal to, generally what do you write? power, let me write e power, sorry, expectation of e power is y. That is the definition, right? But what is y? Ax plus b. Now you can write, otherwise let me prove here. So y equal to ax plus b. Okay. Now its transform equal to expectation of e power sy. But y equal to ax plus b, that's why it become e power s into ax plus b. Okay. Now you can write that as e power, expectation of e power s ax into e power sb. Here e power sb is independent of random variable. So you can keep that outside the expectation. E power sb into e power, expectation of e power sax. But what is this? E power, expectation of e power sx is mx of s. Now this is, please be careful, e power sb into mx of what? Sa. So same thing is being written. So this is the final formula. Okay. Okay. So let us move on to one of the important topics regarding this transform, that is moments from the transforms. Okay. Here, what will you do? What we will do? So we will find moments from the transforms. Okay. Okay. First of all, what are the moments? What about the nth moment of a random variable x? What the formula? Expectation of x power n. That is called as x power n. That is called as nth moment, whose formula is, suppose if it is a continuous random variable, expectation of this equal to integration minus to plus infinity x power n fx of x dx, isn't it? Now, so as I told you just now, transform is also called as moment generating function. Why it is called so? Because this transform can generate the moments. What are the moments? What is the first order moment? First order means n equal to 1. What about n equal to 1? Which means expectation of x. The first moment is nothing but mean. What about second moment? Expectation of x square is called second moment. So expectation of x cube is called third moment. So like this. So you can generate these moments from the transform. How? Let us see. Now, first of all, let us take the formula of this transform, m of s, continuous variable, random variable. So minus to plus infinity e power sx fx of x dx. This is the formula. Now here what I do is, I will differentiate both sides with respect to x, s. Differentiate with respect to variable s on both sides. What will happen? So this becomes m dash of s into, now here in the integral we have only term which is depends upon s is e power sx. Now that's why we only differentiate this term. So rest of the terms are independent of s, so we don't touch them. What is differentiation of e power sx with respect to s? What do you get? X into e power sx fx of x dx. Now here it is true for all values of s. Now here if I keep if s equal to 0, what will happen? If I keep s equal to 0, which means m dash of s when s equal to 0 equal to what? If s equal to 0, this will become 1. So simply this is minus 2 integration minus 2 plus infinity x into fx of x dx. What is this? That is nothing but what? Expectation of x. So you got a first moment. How you got a first moment? Differentiate the transform and substitute s equal to 0. So in the same way, if I differentiate with n times, let's take dn of m of s by d s power n, then what do you get? Any guesses? What do you get? And after that you should keep s equal to 0. If you do so, what do you get? Integration minus 2 plus infinity x power n fx of x dx. But what is this equal to? Nth moment. Okay, so simply the logic is, if you want second moment, so you should differentiate two times and after that substitute s equal to 0, isn't it? Okay, so let us go to this problem. Just now we solved one problem. I told you to remember this problem. So we'll find the mean of this problem using MGF. Mean and variance also you can find out. So let us solve this. Okay, so here I am writing directly. So okay, let me write the function px of x. It is 1 by 2 if x equal to what? 2. 1 by 6 if x equal to 3. 1 by 3 if x equal to 5. So what is the transform we got? How much you got? E power 2s by 2 plus e power 3s by 6 plus e power 5s by 3. Is it okay? Now, so from this transform, you should get moments. From this transform, I want to find moments. So what about the mean of this? Mean means what? How to get mean? Mean is nothing but first moment, that is, which means differentiate this once with respect to s and keep s equal to 0. What do you get? If you do so, what do you get? So differentiate this with respect to s once. What do you get? First. What do you get? E power 2s. E power 2s into 2 by 2, no? Next, what do you get? E power 3s by plus e power 3s by 2. Am I right? E power 3s by 2 plus 5 by 3 e power 5s. Now this is the differentiation of that transform. Keep s equal to 0. Then what is the thing you get? 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 3. 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 3. So what do you get? So this is 3 by 2 plus 5 by 3. 19 by 6. Am I right? So you can check whether this is correct or not by directly finding the mean of this random variable with using this PMF. Now if I want variance, what is the variance of X formula? Expectation X square minus mean square. You got mean. What is second moment? How to find second moment? What do? You double differentiate this function with respect to S and substitute S equal to 0. Here no need to do double differentiation. Already you done once. You do one more time here and keep S equal to 0. So you get the answer. So what you get is you get expectation of S square equal to 71 by 6. You calculate on your own. Okay. So like this, you can find the moments of given random variable if you know the its transform. So that's why it's also called as, the transform is also called as moment generating function, because it generates moments of those random variables. Moments means mean, variance, third moment, fourth moment, so on so on. Okay. Next. Okay, so inversion of a random variable, inversion of a transform, sorry. So it is just like, you know, trial and error method. So this is simply property. So here, yeah, actually using pattern matching from the known tables. So same thing we'll do in case of Laplace also, if you remember properly. So in Laplace also, how we find out inverse? We know the standard Laplace transform pairs. From that, we'll find out the inverse, isn't it? Suppose, so if, suppose e power x of t equal to e power at, e power minus at, let us take. What it is transform? 1 by s plus a, isn't it? So like that, we have some standard pairs, Laplace transform pairs. So by using those pairs, we'll find out the inverse. Here also, more or less, we do same. Okay, so let us take a simple problem here. Suppose if I give you a transform, discrete transform, the transform of a discrete random variable. So it is, let us take e power minus s by 4 plus 1 by 2 plus e power 4 s by 8 plus e power 5 s by 8. So from this, can you get the inverse? Which means, so inverse means what here? PMF. How to find out? First of all, if x is discrete, what is the transform formula? M of s equal to summation over x e power sx and its PMF. So observe this and tell me, what is the values of this PMF? Here e power sx should be there. Here we have e power minus s, means x should be equal to our minus 1, correct? So the first term is probability that capital X equal to minus 1 is how much? What is the corresponding multiplier? 1 by 4. So this should be 1 by 4. Otherwise, Px of minus 1 is 1 by 4. Observe this term. So nothing is there. Means X should be 0. Isn't it? So next is probability that X equal to 0 is how much now? There is no e power s term, that's why x should be 0, that is 1 by 2. So this should be 1 by 2, which means this should be px of 0, isn't it? Next, what is the next term? E power 4s means x is 4, which means probability that x equal to 4. How much is the 4 means 1 by 8, which means px of 4 is 1 by 8. What the last term? E power 5s by 8, which means probability that x equal to 5, that is also equal to 1 by 8. That means px of 5. So just by pattern matching, you got the inverse of this transform. Now what is the PMF finally? What is that? So what you can write? It is 1 by 4 if x equal to minus 1. It is 1 by 2 if x equal to 0. It is 1 by 8 if x equal to 4. Again 4 and 5, right? 4 and 5 is 1 by 8. 0 elsewhere. Like this you can find out. You do one thing. We have solved one problem, no? So from that problem also you find out inverse. For this problem. So from the transform, try to get inverse. Just by pattern matching. Okay? Yeah. So we'll discuss one more important topic. So that is, okay, sum of independent random variables. Okay, so in the last classes we have discussed about these type of problems. Suppose if w equal to sum of two random variables, I have taken w here, then what is the pdf of this w? Sorry, W, no? What is that? If they are independent, not only that, and independent, what do you do? Fx of small w convolution fi of small w, or z, you can also write z. Okay, so without using generality, let me write z only for your understanding. You have just do convolution of two given PDFs. Okay, so remember, it is true if and only if x and y are independent. So if they are not independent, what formula you will write? There are two formulas, minus to plus infinity fx of x comma z minus x dx, or you can also write reverse, I mean dy with respect to y also. I told you all these things in the last classes. Okay, leave it. Now here, so what is the advantage of using transforms in case of sum of two random variables? In the statement itself, they mentioned they are independent. So here, so now I am taking w equal to sum of two random variables x plus y, which are independent of each other. Now, so what is the transform of this w? What is the transform of this w? Let me find out. So mw of s equal to e power sw, but w equal to x plus y. Now here, since x and y are independent, we can write separately. See, I can able to write like this if and only if x and y are independent. Then what happens? So this is the meaning. Okay, here in the problem, in the statement itself we have mentioned. So the addition of independent random variables corresponds to multiplication of transforms. So just multiply two transforms. Okay, suppose here I have taken only two random variables. If I take more number of random variables, sum of random variables, x1 plus x2, x1 plus x2, so on, plus xn. Then what do you write? The product of the corresponding transforms. Isn't it? See, so these things are not new to you actually. Suppose same thing, there is a property called convolution property or modulation property, something like. So x of t convolution h of t. If taking the another domain, x of s into h of s, isn't it? So convolution in time domain becomes product in frequency domain. This property we have studied. Same thing here. So we are convolving these two PDFs in one domain. In other domain, they will be multiplied. Isn't it? So let me write here. If z equal to x plus y and x and y are independent, please make a note of this. If they are independent only, these things are valid. Then the transform of this z equal to, what is that? Transform of x into transform of y. So the transform is product of two transforms. But what is their PDF? It is convolution of two corresponding PDFs. This is the analogy you can think of, isn't it? Okay. Now here, so in the last class we have solved one problem of z equal to x plus y. If you remember, you do one thing. So we have solved one problem of discrete random variable using this summation. Yeah. So here, what you have done? You have done using one method. Here, z equal to x plus y, isn't it? So we have found out f z of z by using convolution property. So what answer you got? So what you got? Okay, so sorry, here I should mention PMF, no? It is PZ of Z. You got answer. So if I write this answer, it is 1 by 6 when Z equal to 1, 5 by 18. So let me write here. Let me take one more page. So remember that formula, that problem. So what you got is p z of z equal to, this is a PDF you got, okay? So this is 1 by 6 when z equal to 1, it is 5 by 18 when z equal to 2, it is 1 by 3 when z equal to 3, it is again 1 by 6 when z equal to 4. It is again 1 by 18 when z equal to 5. This is the answer you got. Z equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here, what I am asking you is, we have done using one method. What method? P z of z equal to convolution of corresponding PMFs. Now do one thing. So here you take transform of this random variable x. You find out mx of s. You find out transform of this random variable also, m by of s. Then what is transform of z? What is that? So the transform of z would be mz of s would be equal to product of two transforms. Okay, you get transform of this. So from the transform, you want PMF. How it is possible? By inversion. So are you getting what I want to say? So in the previous classes we have solved one problem. You got its PMF of Z. Now here we use this property of transforms. So find the transform of X, transform of Y, multiply these two, you get transform of Z. But from this take inverse, you get PM of Z. This is one more way of finding. You solve it. Okay. So right. So we stop here.